with us as we return for more Tuesday Night Fights from Stockton, California. In Stockton, California, for USA's Tuesday Night Fights. Tonight's boxing is brought to you by Pabst. When someone asks, what do you have? Say, Pabst Blue Ribbon Beer. And now, for our main event, let's go to ring announcer Fred Tosi.
Is Terry Smith. All right, this is a middleweight 10 rounder. Introducing in the blue corner from Vallejo, California, weighing in this afternoon at 161 pounds in the red trunks. Introducing with the record of 26 wins, 2 losses, no draws, 20 knockouts. Ladies and gentlemen, strikes. He weighed in this afternoon at 167.5 pounds from Stockton, California. He has a record of 31, 5 losses, and 19 by knockout. Introducing, ladies and gentlemen, Fabulous Freddie Hutchins.
Gentlemen, you're the 2 seconds, you'll be responsible for the corners. Yeah, I've given you instructions already. Just remember, fight a hard fight and a clean fight. Good luck to both of you. Come on, fight.
Let's check the tail of the tape between these two fighters, Hutchins and Rival. You see the size difference in them. Both the same age. Hutchins with a height advantage. Tad of a reach advantage of 6 inches. How will that affect the fight?
Well, if you can keep Roy Val out on the end of his punches, he'll win the fight. Plain and simple.
Roy Val has got some punching power. 26-2 with 20 KOs. That's a good ratio. That's the way he's got to fight this fight, too. He's got to stay right on top of Fred Hutchins. They call Fred the Pumper.
Fred Hutchins, record of 31-5, 19 KOs. He says he's going to fight this fight anyway. Eduardo Robal wants to fight it. He says if Robal wants to trade, he'll stay on the inside and trade with
him. Would that be wise for a man so much taller?
I think he'll be fighting the fight of Robal. Robal can only fight one kind of fight. That's stay on top of the other opponent because of the height difference and the reach difference.
I'm Steve Grad with former light middleweight champion Sean O'Grady. And Rival charges right in there.
And Hutchins caught him with a good left hook while he was coming in. Short, quick, and fast.
In the amateur ranks, Rival was 96-18.
It was a good left hook.
We saw
Auburn Hines, they come back from a 21-month layoff, and it didn't affect him at all. So it can be done.
Scheduled 10-round middleweight fight.
Lots of wrestling going on in here. Neck and shit taken out of your 10-round
middleweight. Round one. Ready to close between Hutchins and Auburn and Roy Ball. Says that Hutchins better run for 10 rounds because he's going to take body shots with my left foot if he stays in there with me.
And that's what Phil Melton told Fred Hutchins between rounds. Melton, the trainer of Hutchins, told him, said, you got to run, you got to box. That's what he's doing the first part of this round. Now he's hanging on, tie him up on the inside. And when you're out of the end, out of the outside, stay on the outside, he says.
Following instructions well. Continue to pour in, he'll take his shots. In 82, he took a shot that broke his jaw. Kept it on a boxing grill yet.
It takes two to get one of his. And he's got some power in his hands.
Good 1-2, well done.
And he takes it left hook.
He's got Hutchins moving in a clockwise position to his left. Again, body shots landing with left hooks by Roy Ball.
Roy Ball, the aggressor here in the second round.
There's a right that puts him to his knees. Hutchins with that right. Did he slip?
Referee's doing a slip. There was no knockdown.
Good uppercut by Hutchins. He had a fight against Thomas Hearns. He's blasted in the third round TKO. He's had a taste of glory before and he wants it again.
His whole career has kind of been a roller coaster ride. That loss to Hearns really disturbed him. He still has nightmares about that incident. He was KO'd in the third round by Hearns. If Hutchins wins tonight, his manager says that he has a verbal commitment to fight the world champion.
Combination by Hutchins. My ball might have been stunned, he finishes it.
Back and forth, both men trade exchanging great punches. Hutchins is trying to get down low, get down to the same level as Roy Ball. Should never let a fighter underneath you. And Hutchins is trying to live up to that rule. Fighter gets underneath you, he can come up under your punches, under your guard. Hutchins working the uppercut here, good. He should use that uppercut a lot against the shorter man in Mardo Roval.
Second round, nearing its end. Hutchins with a couple of blows. Hutchins might have slipped. Both fighters in this round, the second round is a bell ring. Hit the canvas for a brief second, both on the pair of slips, but there were some good shots thrown.
They were hit while they were slipping. However, there must be some water over in that corner of Fred Hutchins, because that's exactly where he slipped. Here's another look at that slip. Dry on his feet. Right here is where it happens. Yeah, he just takes a step back and he slips somehow in the corner. He's got on the old type boxing shoes that are not rubber sole. They're the old leather soles and they're real, real slick. What he might do is scrape them up a little bit on the bottom with a sharp blade like a knife or something to give him some more traction. Roy Ball, so calm and relaxed. This is early in this fight, coming up on the third round. There's the referee over in the corner telling the corner man of Fred Hutchins to clean some of that water out.
Body shots by Roy Ball.
Taller of the two, Fred Hutchins, trying to lay some of that weight on top of Margot Roy Ball.
just backing away from a possible right tackle follow up. So I don't know if that punch was as effective as the stoppage.
Chins, especially of a guy like Roy Bob, he's protecting it. That head down, he's in that crouch, and he pours in. And he gets a body shot to Hutchins. Good body shot for a year ago.
A lot of times in the punches, you hit a guy on top of the head, it hurts your hands, then you hit him on the elbow, and that'll hurt your hands also. Roy Bob has got a good defense, and locks up into a shell. That's another reason why Hutchins is getting down so low. He's squats down. Good jab by Hutchins.
Roy Bob
comes back to the right
and zone. The right caught by Bob. Chant of Freddy for Hutchins goes up by the